So just coming into the experience of this present moment, noticing the body sitting. Getting a generalized sense of the body in this space. And noticing if you can make yourself any more comfortable to help yourself settle, really arrive here. And really take your time with this. If something needs adjusting, or if your shoulders need a bit of a roll. So that you have a soft but alert posture. And just noticing the atmosphere, the particular sounds, sense of people sitting together. And a sense of the space in the room. The absence of things to do, things to worry about, all the work set aside. The absence of the morning commute. Traffic, the absence of needing to be anything special. There are no demands on you at all. And see if you can find some sense of delight, relaxation, ease by noticing what's missing. Taking time to appreciate that. Now gently coming into the present moment by noticing what's pleasant. Perhaps extending your awareness beyond the body, to the atmosphere, to the sounds. Putting down the heavy burdens of the past, the proliferations around the future. And starting to recognize the presence of this moment. And offering kindness to the moment, noticing your relationship to whatever you're experiencing, and opening your heart to that by really listening in with a sense of interest, curiosity, and welcome. You're just a passive observer, unconcerned with the content of experience, but just concerned with making peace, being kind and being gentle to every moment as it manifests. Listening to what it has to teach us rather than talking back. And if any sound comes to your mind, see if you can notice not only the sound, but also the ending of that sound, disappearing, stilling, quietening of that sound. And the silence it leaves in its wake. Remembering to soften your awareness so that it's not coming in and contracting around experience or sound, but your awareness remains spacious, expansive, receptive, allowing things to come in and pass away. As you recognize the silence between the sounds or between your thoughts, see if you can become familiar with that experience and find some rest, some ease, even delight in the spaces between the words. As you notice silence, you may start to find that silence grows and develops in the mind. Without trying to pull her in or grab hold, when you treat her with kindness as a friend, silence wants to stay. So just maintain this very gentle, kind, receptive attitude, valuing every experience, recognizing, becoming familiar, and becoming at ease with the silent spaces. And as you find there's more space, more quiet in the mind, you may become more aware of the breath happening, or the body sensations. And you'll notice that these things too are happening silently in the body. Leading you towards unity, towards peace. So if the mind feels inclined, you can use the breathing or the sensations to bring you more and more into the stillness of the present moment. Noticing their calming, quietening effect. Allowing them to bring you into their silent world. So we're coming close to the end of the meditation. Just notice how you feel. Notice if the mind has become quieter or more peaceful. And really drink that in with appreciation. Even the quietness of one breath. now ring the bell and invite you to listen, not only to the sound of the bell, but to the spaces between the bells. It's lunchtime now, and again, I'd really like to encourage you just to really notice and appreciate any amount of quietening or peace that you've developed and treat it like a precious jewel, so that your body and your activities now keep on adding and building up that peace. So just noticing when the activity starts to become a little fast or habitual, or you know, lots of thinking starts to arise in the mind, and just really noticing that and making the intention to let it go and come back to quietness of the body and the mind. Yeah? So especially around food, there can be quite a lot of commotion and sometimes stress, worried that there won't be enough, but there's plenty. And I think we can really support each other by just maintaining very calm and quiet bodily activity. And also, if you want to take the opportunity, I'd really invite you to rest after the lunch, whether you want to be outside on the grass doing slow walking or on the balcony here, or just take a blanket or a yoga mat and curl up in the room. So just aware that, you know, people will be doing that, and so we can walk very quietly past them. My teacher calls it burglar meditation. You walk as though you're up to something, you know. You don't want anyone to know you're there. So take it as an opportunity to just become a little bit invisible. And we'll meet again at about 1:15. Yeah, so you've got lots of time.